Hello! Today we're going to read from Usborne's Fairy Tales. And today I have a wolf stuffed animal with me. Can anyone guess what fairy tale we're going to hear? Well, if you guessed Little Red Riding Hood, you'd be correct. It's Little Red Riding Hood. Okay. Once upon a time, there was a little girl called Little Red Riding Hood, who always wore a ruby red cloak. "I love the way it swishes and sways," she would say. She lived near a deep, dark forest where her mother kept bees and her father chopped down trees. One day, Little Red Riding Hood's mother gave her a pot of honey. "Please, will you take this to Grandma on the other side of the forest?" Little Red Riding Hood skipped through the forest, singing a little song. "I'm so happy with the birds and bees. Nothing's going to happen to me in these trees." "Hello," called her father as she skipped along. "Hello," Little Red Riding Hood replied. But someone else was watching Little Red Riding Hood. Can you see who it is? Who do you think it is? Is it the wolf? What a rascally little wolf. That's right, it was a wolf. A little girl, ooh, how delicious. How I'd love to gobble her up. Nor was that just any old wolf, oh no. This was a crafty, clever, cunning wolf who loved to set traps. The wolf quickly hung a net beneath a tree and waited for Little Red Riding Hood to come closer and closer and closer until skip, skip, skibbity, skip, she sailed right over the net. "Rats," snarled the wolf. "Oh no." The wolf raced ahead and dug a large hole in the ground, then covered it in leaves. Skip, skippity, skip, Little Red Riding Hood, while she got closer and closer and closer until she skipped right over the hole. The wolf pounced and missed. "Rats," he hissed. She foiled his plan. "Time for my last plan," he said. And grinning and giggling, he raced to Grandma's cottage and he knocked on the door. Rat, tat, 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 tat. He waited for Grandma to come to the door. Then he gobbled her up in one hungry gulp. Ooh, bony, but not bad. "That's a naughty wolf. We don't eat Grandma." "Now for dessert," chuckled the wolf. "Ha ha ha ha." He pulled on Grandma's clothes, leaped into her bed, and waited for some more. At last, there came a tap, tap, tap on the door. "Oh, Grandma," said Little Red Riding Hood, skipping into the room. "There's something different about you today." "What do you think's different about Grandma?" "My, what big ears you have," said Little Red Riding Hood, coming closer. "Oh, all the better to hear you with," said the wolf. "And what big eyes you have," Little Red Riding Hood had come closer still. "Oh, all the better to see you with," said the wolf.
Oh, what's going to happen?
"Oh, Grandma, what big, hairy hands you have," said Little Red Riding Hood. "Oh, all the better to hug you with," said the wolf, and he grinned. "But what big teeth you have." "Yes, all the better to eat you with," cried the wolf. "Oh no!" In one bound, the wolf leaped out of the bed and gobbled up Little Red Riding Hood. What a naughty wolf. Then he went to sleep with a full tummy and a very satisfied smile on his whiskery face. But the wolf didn't realize that this time he was being watched. Oh, is Daddy gonna come to the rescue? Little Red Riding Hood's father smashed his way into the cottage. He took one look at that wolf's belly, grabbed some scissors, and snipped him open. Out popped Little Red Riding Hood and her grandma, safe and sound. Now it was Grandma who was crafty, clever, and cunning. "Run outside," she said to Little Red Riding Hood, "and fetch me some nice round pebbles." Then she dropped the pebbles into the wolf's tummy, and she stitched him up. Isn't sewing fun? I've never done that kind of sewing. The pages are stuck. When the wolf woke up, he clutched his belly. He howled and howled and howled. He ran outside, and the stones went rattling and clattering inside of him. "I'll never be able to gobble up any humans ever again," he moaned. "Everyone will hear me coming." As for Little Red Riding Hood, she went skippity skip 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 all the way home in her ruby red cloak, swishing and swaying behind her. The end.